Hello and welcome to The Loop. I'm Matt Bruning.
And I'm Renata Ford. Ohio is the heart of it all, officially.
With a change in the state's branding comes an update to the state's welcome signs.
The ODOT sign shop has been working to build the new signs and get them out to the various parts of the state where crews can begin installing them.
All the words that are back behind me are applied by hand by our workers. Real fast process for them. It can seem daunting from someone from the outside looking at it, but we've been doing this for many years and we've got the process pretty much down pat.
A total of 36 signs are going up at major entry points to the state. The goal is to have them all installed by December.
Work on a new diverging diamond interchange near Youngstown is getting underway.
This is the first diverging diamond interchange here in Northeast Ohio. So while it may take a little bit of time getting used to driving on the opposite side of the road, these interchanges are proven safer by eliminating left turns against oncoming traffic and providing better sight distance.
So we're excited about kicking this off and we're excited about this project. I'll just pledge to everybody be patient during construction and keep your eye on the prizes when we get it done.
The state's first diverging diamond interchange, or DDI, was installed in the Columbus area at I-270 and Roberts Road back in 2013.
A national study found that DDIs reduced deadly crashes by an average of 54%. The main reason for this? They eliminate left turns across oncoming traffic. Right now, there are only a handful of these in Ohio.
Construction on this project is expected to be completed by the fall of 2026.
DriveOhio is doing some amazing things.
Who knew?
Wow. You really are a dad.
Over the past 200 years, Ohio has been home to many technological innovators and pioneers in science. Charles Kettering, Garrett Morgan, the Wright brothers, the list goes on. We're continuing that tradition at ODOT through DriveOhio, specifically in the advancement of electric vehicle infrastructure. Our Director of Communications, Brianna Badanes, along with Project Manager Santos Ramos, tells us more.
A barrier right now for a lot of electric vehicle drivers is the lack of charging stations. So a lot of the charging is done at home. They do most of their charging overnight. But if they want to travel long distance or travel to other states, there's really a lack of that infrastructure to enable that travel. The National Electric Vehicle Infrastructure, or NEVI program, intends to implement electric vehicle charging stations every 50 miles on key corridors throughout the state to increase that long distance travel possibilities for EV drivers. It's really all hands on deck. We have several consultants helping us out, and we hired this great new project manager, Santos Ramos, who is an EV driver himself, so he offers a great perspective to the program and what EV drivers really want and need when we're implementing these stations.
I'll be using a DC fast charger, direct current, so difference between that and a level 2 or level 1, which is what you would charge at home with or at work, is we're using direct current on this bad boy instead of alternating current.
We are going to be working electric vehicle infrastructure for years to come, but hopefully the next time we talk to you, we will be breaking ground for the first NEVI station in the nation.
Thanks, guys. At DriveOhio, we're proud to be tasked with the research, planning, and deployment of cutting-edge technology. From people to projects, DriveOhio's goal is to make our transportation system safe, accessible, and positioned for the future. Who knew?
Thanks, guys. Governor Mike DeWine has launched a new $100 million program to help eliminate dangerous railroad crossings. Ohio has approximately 5,700 of these crossings. These funds will help communities across the state apply for a larger federal program.
Railroad-grade crossings are both a safety hazard and a barrier to traffic, including emergency vehicles. Since the Federal Railroad Administration began collecting blocked crossing data in late 2019, more than 10,500 reports of blocked crossings in Ohio have been filed.
Municipalities can submit railroad crossing elimination projects to the Ohio Rail Development Commission, which will identify the projects with the best opportunities for federal funding and assist in developing these locations into competitive federal grant applications.
Get more news from ODOT online at transportation.ohio.gov. Follow us on social media and keep sending those great story ideas and feedback to loop@dot.ohio.gov.
And now you're in the loop.